Matty by the sea. Good afternoon, dude. How are you? Guess where we are?
ATL underscore Ropal says hello.
Oh, good afternoon, Rob. How are you? Good afternoon. Hope you can hear me. We are today at the allotment. It's Tuesday afternoon. And we've got a beautiful sunny day. Sun's up there. Sorry to blind you. Didn't mean
Matty
to.
Matty by the sea says, have you recovered the lids?
Well, actually, this one I found, and I found this one in that kind of hedge over there. I did try to sort of look and see if there was another. It was just over in this bit, actually, sort of deep within the brambles. Hello, Chaplin. How you doing, man? Hey, diddling. Alright, that's what I want to do. So yeah, the lid was in here, and I did kind of have a look around to see if there was kind of another lid launched between some tree branches or limbs, and I couldn't see anything. Couldn't see anything over there, and then I did kind of have a look over this way because I think the wind was I don't know what way the wind was blowing, and then I did kind of have a look over here a little bit. So to be honest, I think I was lucky actually to spy that one, and it was a really good colour match for the other bins, so I'm pretty sure. If we go and have a look at the colour match, I am definitely sure that lid is mine because of the colour match. The colour match is really good, isn't it? Hey, lass. How you doing? So the colour match there is really, really, really good. However, this is the one that we did find, and the colour match isn't quite as good, so I think that one actually belongs to another bin somewhere, but I don't know quite where. So yeah, I think we're going to be binless on one bin, but that's that. Tonight I'm going to be making some curry. Actually, I need to take this cabbage home. You see that's where the pigeons are sort of starting to peck it and really get in there. And I think I'd rather that's a really decent sized cabbage, that one. If you look at my hand, I've got quite big hands, I think. So that's, I suppose it's got to be head size, that cabbage. So yeah, I want to take that one home and eat that before the pigeons actually eat any more of it. But I do need to take a little bit of cabbage home to make a base curry sauce. Jelly Bean, thank you for the host, man. So yeah, one of these cabbages is probably going to probably come home with me. I don't know which one. Maybe that little one there, or I only need like I think 2 ounces of cabbage really. The chickens are probably like that one. I don't think is ever going to heart up. I don't know if you can see. I don't think that one's ever going to heart up. So I'll probably take that one home for the chickens. The chickens are like that. And then swede. You know, we've been eating swede all through the winter, but we've still got loads left. I think we've eaten probably half a row. So maybe next year I need to give more away. So yeah, that's kind of where we are. The purple sprouting broccoli sort of keeps sprouting. I took some home for dinner, but it looks like I've got more to take this week as well. It's really, really, really sprouting. Not very long sprouts, mind you. But there is something there to take, I suppose. So yeah, no, that's all good. Yeah, so definitely this weekend I think I'm going to have some sort of purple sprouting cauliflower cheese, maybe. Maybe sort of all those little sprouts chopped up with a little bit of cauliflower. Maybe kind of a red Leicester cheese sauce will complement the purple and the white cauliflower. Delicious. So today we are... I was actually looking for a stick when you guys turned up. Today we've got this area. So we weren't here last week. Why weren't we here? Ah, because I lost my job last week. This area here is where we've talked about the potatoes going. And literally, I've been down here ever since Christmas, really. Just turning it over one row at a time, save my back and not make it back-breaking work. And then yesterday, I got the rotavator out of the shed. I can show you the rotavator in a minute. And I've been up and down and up and down and kind of made it into a fairly sort of... it's quite warm, this soil. Sort of fairly fine, crumbly texture. You know, it's a big stone, so it's never going to get smaller. But yeah, we've got kind of a nice soil to be working with. I'm going to plant three rows of potatoes today. I don't quite know where I'm going to put you. I want to put you on the tripod, maybe. Maybe we'll have to use the wheelbarrow and I'll stick you to the little arch bits upside down. Or maybe you could sit in the tree. Maybe tree vision might be better, I don't know. I do kind of think, maybe you can just... Oh, head cam. Maybe I could stick you on the head cam, maybe. It's probably a better idea than that. Cool. So this is the area that I've been up and down, up and down, up and down, rotavating. And it's just a noisy, old, clunky machine. The clunky machine is over here. Oh, but we've had the accident as well. Expanding foam. I bought... You know I've got this coffin boat that I'm going to sail with Ticken, and Ticken thinks that I'm going to sink. Well, I thought, every time I go and get some materials, if I buy a can of expanding foam, I'll have a few in my armoury, and I won't ever know the cost of it. Well, yes, was it yesterday? Yeah, I think it was yesterday. I was down here. What was I doing? Oh, I cut a bit of wood, and I threw the saw in the van. Well, I didn't kind of throw it. I threw it into the bit of the van where the saw kind of lives. But also, there's a can of expanding foam. And I think one of the teeth must have just grabbed... Not grabbed anything, pierced a little bit of the expanding foam. So yeah, I've got little blobs of expanding foam all over the allotment. Oh, but it really does expand well. So I think I've lost a fiver on the expanding foam. But what I have learnt is that was only a little blob yesterday, and a little blob goes into quite a big thingy. And I think that's really quite. But it's definitely going to play a major part in the coffin. And over here we kind of had a bit of a bigger blob. And it's turned into this. It's like a fucking mushroom. It's well stuck to the side over here. Look at this. Look how massive this is. That's like, this was... I can't even remember how big the blob was. The blob wasn't very big, to be honest. It was maybe fist size. So that's really expanded, like, well. And do you see how shiny it is? That is definitely... I think that's definitely got to be waterproof. Definitely got to be waterproof. So, yeah, this, right, this is what I see. It is massive, isn't it? This is like... I was a bit upset that we had, like... This is the... I tried to bandage it up. There's still stuff in there. I might still be able to use this can, because I'm hoping that where I bandaged it up, that it's kind of sealed itself. I think that's where it was all bubbling out from. So I'm kind of hoping that the can sealed itself, and... I'm going to be able to still use it. Otherwise, there's a whole load of liquid in there that I don't know will ever turn into foam. Ooh. So yeah, no, it's just unfortunate, I suppose. It teaches you one thing: don't throw your saw into a van with expanding foam. I've got expanding foam on my coat. It was a right old nightmare, I'll tell you. It's an absolute. This is kind of one of those things where you think, no, why now? So. Yeah, it was messy. So I've got kind of like all these little bubbles of expanding foam. Can you imagine? I don't know if you can imagine, really. It was just like snow coming out. You know, in a shop window when they put on those Christmas displays and they've got all those bobble, what do they call it? Polystyrene, sort of all blown around the shop front. It was a bit like that. The cam was just like sort of spraying snow everywhere. And when I realised it was all up my coat sleeve and on the front of me, I was like, oh no, what am I doing? And then I tried to stick it in water. I don't know why I stuck it in water. I thought that might seal the hole for some stupid reason, but no, that didn't work. So yeah, I bandaged it. And after a while, it did stop to sort of hitting and stuff. So I kind of think that, I don't know. So yeah, that was kind of the disaster yesterday afternoon. But we're here this afternoon. We've rotivated the bit that we want to go, and these are all the potatoes. So when we put the potatoes in here, oh, it must have been. What are we talking now, Matt? We must be talking. Oh, Jamonite Mac, hello, dude. I can show you, actually, the greenhouse in a minute before we get planting. Should we go and actually have a look in the greenhouse? No, let's do the potatoes. So, the potatoes, they had what we called the rose end. The rose end's got more buds on. If you look at a potato, Jamonite Mac, you will see that one end's got, they call it the rose end, and it's got more kind of, but they call it buds, but you'll probably see it as eyes or something of your potato, whereas the other end's really smooth. So we've had these potatoes here chitting for about, I don't know, maybe 4 weeks, 4 or 5 weeks now. And some of them have got really nice little shoots there. They're strong. You know when your potatoes, you leave them in the cupboard and you forget about them and you're like, ah, the potatoes, and they've got these great long shoots and they're really quite unhealthy, whereas if you put them out in the sunlight, those shoots just turn into like little strong green shoots. Yes, I am planting these, but these aren't potatoes that I've grown last year and saved. These are actually seed potatoes. They come from Scotland. So this tray in the middle here, I don't know whether you can see, the tray in the middle there is a variety called Cara. They're really good for jacket potatoes. When you put them in the oven and, I suppose, roast them, the skins, oh my god, they turn so crispy. Like the
good afternoon at DJ underscore technique. How you doing, mate? We got you on our big screen in the studio. DJ John 20 Van Dam Oddy JJ Rise. 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 DJ John.
Hey, Pure Dance Radio. How you going? I forget where I was. Yeah, so these make a really good jacket potato. So yeah, these came from Scotland. They're kind of all certified. They've got a plant passport and yeah, that's without going into too much kind of boring shit about plant passports and this, that and the other. So they should be certified disease-free. That's one of the reasons that I buy fresh potatoes every year.
All good, mate.
Is just to try and make sure that I've got fresh disease-free stock, because if I kept the potatoes from down here, we get aphids on the potatoes and they carry viruses, and potentially the potato that you keep has got a virus, and then it's just easier to keep fresh seeds. So in here, Jam, the greenhouse, I need to get on my bloody Discord. Oh, it's really lovely and warm in here. And I've got a few photos of what we've been doing over the weeks. Ah, yeah, definitely, definitely, definitely. Over the weeks, I've got some pictures to sort of build a bit of a vlog or something, I don't know, something like that. We've got here loads of stuff. These are the poppies that we sowed a few weeks ago, so they're coming up really good. There's hundreds in each pot, which is really good, because hopefully out of each little cell, hundreds will turn into, say, 20s, and that would dwindle into sort of maybe one or two really strong plants. We've got beetroot over there. I just need to, where that cell's got 3 beetroot in, I just need to pinch the two weakest ones, leaving 1 plant in each cell. We've got dwarf sunflowers here. These only grow to about 60 centimetres tall. They're going to look really lovely on my patio. And we've got, these were planted middle of February, so we've got another batch to plant that we'll probably plant 6 weeks after that, so whenever 6 weeks is after the middle of February. Probably somewhere around beginning of April, first half of April, I would have thought. We've got our Brussels sprouts here. Hopefully today we might have time to get the cold frame.
Says you were busy. Nice job.
Yeah, I'm trying to come down here every Tuesday with you guys and sort of build up a bit of a picture. We've made this metal frame together. So some of you that have been here from the beginning, I think we've only been sort of doing the allotment streams for about the last maybe 5 weeks or so. We've built this metal frame. We've pruned the apple tree. We've done loads of different stuff. So hopefully, as the year goes on, every Tuesday is going to kind of add another kind of, task to our list. Hopefully, the way I kind of vision it is in June, July time, when we're sat on the patio having a barbecue, looking at all the sunflowers on the patio, sort of reflecting about, how nice the summer is and, how all the plans we've got going forward. We're about to sort of kind of also talk about how the sunflowers were when they were kind of tiny little seedlings emerging from the pots. So yeah, no, we've got, and peas. These are our peas. These are coming up really well. So yeah, no, they're all doing well. But today we are actually planting potatoes. Oh, I wonder if those metal poles are going to be any use. I need to pull strings. Will they be any good? Right, just cut a bit of bamboo cane. Oh no, I've got those actually. That's a good idea. Okay, so that's the greenhouse. We'll probably come back in there because I want to plant a few more lettuce today. We'll see what happens. What am I doing in here? We need to kind of measure some rows. I've got these metal poles. I thought I'd add some more. 1, 2. Oh. Well, I was going to bring the drill down as well, but I forgot. I'm going to keep the door open, maybe with a spade. Now I've taken the stake away. Cool. So I've got three stakes. I thought I had more than just three. I know I've got one on the greenhouse. But I thought I had another one. Okay, so, three stakes there. Plus that. How many do I need? I need just two, really, don't I? Actually, I do need another one. I thought I had four of those stakes. I got one in the greenhouse. Yeah, I thought I had four of those black ones. I lost my crowbar the other week as well. Went on a job. And I think that I left my crowbar there. And then when I went back, it wasn't. So, it's really annoying. Okay. Hokey dokey. Right. We'll use this one. Fine. So I'm going to need some string.
F1NALM1GHTMARE3V3 says hiya DJ underscore technique.
Hey, fine nightmare. How you doing, man? What's that falling? I thought something had fallen over. We are just getting ready to plant some potatoes. I think we're way ahead of the game this year.
Do_SEKU_ARD says hi DJ and chat.
Hey Dosekoart, how you doing? Welcome to this afternoon stream down the allotment. We've just kind of had a look in the greenhouse and everything, so someone's taken it. I had some string. Yeah, so we'll have a look. Oh, this is the kind of the string that I'm looking for. But I don't think it was actually that bit. Yeah, so I planted potatoes this afternoon, Donna.
ALN1GHTMARE3V3 says, I'm good, dude. HR, are you doing in this lovely sunny weather?
Yeah, no, I'm good. It is really nice and sunny in the greenhouse. It is beautiful. It baffles me what happens to all my bits of, all my bits of string. I'm sure I had, like, a bundle somewhere. Yeah, no, I'm really good, thank you. I'm really good. It's been a funny week. What was it, Tuesday? Yeah, so this time last week I lost my job, and then by the afternoon I'd got my job back, but a different round. And it's much smaller than the round that I had before, so... I think all in all, the bottom line is I'm lucky to have a little bit of work. And oh, I'm not going to let it worry me too much. Something will turn up. Something will definitely turn up. How come I can have all these little bundles of string for doing like little lines, and then when you need them, they're just gone? It's not like... Maybe they're out higher.
F1NALN1GHTMARE3V3 says it's always the way.
Yeah, no, they're like little bundles of, you know what builders use to do lines in the bricks, get them all straight? I've bought several bundles of those in the past, and eventually they all get cut down to kind of the right sort of length, which is basically about 15 foot.
Jellybean 1956 says a brick line.
Yeah, brick line, that's exactly it. And they basically get cut down to about 15 foot. And so I've got all these little bundles, and I can't believe that they've just actually just all disappeared. Let me just put you up there for my own chat and have a look in this book. Wouldn't have thought they're at home, but we can only use this one. I just wanted the other ones because just slightly better. This should be long enough.
Xanadu 2020 says, hey, why?
Hey, Xanadu, how you doing? I've just lost probably the most important part of what we made today. Right, we're going to have a tidy up in here and find everything, because it can't just disappear. Something pink in there, oh, it's red. Looks like a pair of gardening gloves. Yeah, three or four great big bundles of orange string can't just disappear. Over there? No? About down there. Oh well, we use this today. Right, let me bring chat with me. Right, okay, so I think the first job, do I need gloves? Don't think I do need gloves just yet. Right, our first job today is to, okay, so we're going to plant a row of early potatoes. So we're planting Charlotte are a sort of waxy salad potato. They don't generally fall apart when you cook them. They're the sort of potato that maybe you would use for a potato salad, or maybe sauteed potatoes, just because they don't fall apart, and that is what they are. So they only need sort of about foot between rows. We haven't got a shit ton of space here, I don't think. What do we want? So if I started a row there, and then the main crops, they really want about 3 foot, 3.5, you know, 3-4 foot between rows. So if that is a row of potatoes there, and that's another foot, say 2 foot. Okay, just a foot. And then, how many feet have we, let me stick that in the ground there. How many feet have we got left? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 ish. 6-ish, 7-ish foot. So if I come from there and go 3 foot up, that will be then the first row. 1, 2, 3. So that should be the start of a second row. Looks like too much, really. It is too much. Right. That's fine. It's divided. Okay, so I've divided that too. So the next row of potatoes kind of needs to go there, and then the next one needs to go there. Sorted. So it's probably 1.5 foot. Is that right? So. Okay, cool, right. Okay, so that first row probably, I didn't go right close up to the strawberries. I left about a foot's width down there. So the row probably wants to be there, 1 foot. Right, let me put you down, Chuck, because I wasn't going to drop you. Right, you stay there. That is going to be a row. Just there. So, yeah, yesterday when I was down here rotivating, I think it took maybe about an hour. Didn't take too long, to be honest. And that probably wants to go about there. Oh, right. I'm going to put you on head cam, I think. Because I think that'd be better. Let's just do the string. I don't remember taking any of the sort of strings home, and there's definitely none left out here as a bundle anyway. I really want to sort the cold fry. I hope this is long enough, but it's not. I really want to sort the cold fry out today. So there's no. I'd be very fucking surprised if that is long enough. Where's all my bits of string? Tell you what. Dragon. I don't know. No. Definitely not. Right, let's have a quick look in the shed, because you can't just lose some bits of string over the winter. Oh, I'll need chat with me, otherwise that's going to be a disaster. Right, come on, chat. Ah! Fuck, I know where. Okay, so I did a fencing job with my dad, and what I've done, maybe my dad's still got a bit of string then, must be a home in my shed. Right, okay, right, that's probably solved the problem that I did take it on a fencing job and left it with my dad or something. I have got, what have we got? This string, which is probably, is it going to be better than this string? This string can sometimes break a bit easier. Oh no, we use this string. Alright. Okay, right, we've saved the day, jelly bean. We saved the day. I might just use this as a bloody. Let's put you there. Okay. Right, that will. Jeez. I think sometimes this string can be like a little bit weak. It does seem to be sort of like a strong string. But I think here, I think where it's like woven or. How do you make string? Do you spin it or weave it or something? Got my knife on me. No. Was it in this pocket? Right, what is the point in having a knife if I don't take it for jobs down the allotment? I mean, I think we're going to put you on the tripod of some sorts. Hey, Big Toe Dan, how you going? How you going, man? We are? Yeah, no, we are wannabe farmers. We've been quite successful wannabe farmers in the past. Alright, don't need that then. So I wonder where that bit of string is then, Dan. I had a bit of string. Well, I used on a fencing job round my dad's, and that is kind of the last time I remember seeing it. I didn't remember not seeing it. Okay, I'm just going to tighten that, just don't want it too tight because I want to be able to slide it up and that. I'm just going to tie. So I think I've bashed your chat. I'm just going to tie it loosely, I think, so I can undo it. Okay, so that's our line, and where am I going to put you? Maybe... Ah, the wheelbarrow. We said that was going to be a good idea. Ah, helmet cap, yes. That's probably way better. Right, let me sort that out in here. Hello. Okay, right, hold your horses just for a moment. Yeah, I think helmet cam's probably... Ah, Mozzie, how are you? Sorry, you're just looking at the ground for a moment. I'm going to put you onto helmet cam, because I think that helmet cam's going to be better for us. We're just planting potatoes this afternoon, Mozzie. So you're just going to have to... You're on your side at the moment. It's nothing. It's not one of those effects or anything. Just trying to screw this. What's that screw? Yeah, the helmet. That's the one. Okay, so let me take my hat off. Right, chat, you are, I think... I need to have a look in a mirror and make sure you're in pointing in the right direction. Okay, I think that's actually better for you guys. Let me put my hat on. I have to wear the hat a bit like a berry now. The string and the scissors can go away. Okay, I think the closest thing to them... Oh, I've got a picture thing on my phone, haven't I? Let's do that, Dick Cam. Yeah, no, it's not quite. Let's turn that around. Let's straighten you up a bit that way. I think that is kind of... Do you want to point down? I think that's... I think you're okay at that angle, maybe. Okay.
Red Mozzie says, oh, not that helmet.
No, sorry. Oh, you thought that's the helmet cam on the OnlyFans site. Okay, cool, right. So we are hopefully gonna get what we're gonna get. I suppose gloves might be a help. So the first potatoes we're gonna plant in that row are these ones here, Charlotte. I need to put chat in the basket of potatoes. Okay. Hello, Davey Baby. How you doing, man? We are outside today in the sunshine. We've got loads of potatoes to plant. And we're going to do it together today. Ah! Oh, that's a long way down there. What do I need? I probably need spring chat with me. That might be a good idea. I probably need like a bit of stick. Oh, it's good that I've chopped all these. Ah, Scott. Yeah, it's really cheap to subscribe for a monthly subscription. I think it's like $12.99. We're doing a special in the month of March. I should do this really outside. So this is going to be a measuring stick. I want to plant these potatoes 12 inches apart. Mozzie knows what 12 inches is, but I need like a little stick. And I'm gonna cut it just there. Cool. Okay, so this is our 12 inch stick. Yes, you are. Really? Blimey. Yeah, I just somehow don't think that I'm ever going to get close to, £100. So yeah, that's my kind of, that's my OnlyFans gone out the wall. Out the window. Yeah, I know. Ah, do I need a rake? Yeah, my Dutch isn't all that Scott. I'm just kind of thinking. Right, let's chuck that down there. Let's get, what is that bit of paper? It's a bloomer. I think they might have come off the metal poles. Ick, a Ben, an Abadol. Yes. I need a rake, Scott. I think we're going to use this rake. Oh, just to flatten things out a little bit. We am a potato. Right. Really, I need chat on my.
Rated Lawless says, "Hey DJ, how's it going down the allotment?"
Hey, Rated Lawless, how you doing, man? Yeah, no, we're doing all right actually today. We are just about to plant our first row of potatoes. So I'm just going to rake this kind of flattish a little bit. I should have probably gone over the whole patch and raked it, but nah, we're not going to bother. Oh, I left chat behind. I need to come and get you guys. I need to come and get you. But that is literally all the raking that I'm doing. Got a fucking great big stone there. Wow. All those big stones. I need to be disposed of. Yeah. Okay. Right, that is literally all the raking I'm doing on that bit. There's some big fucking stones, isn't there? Right, I'll have to chuck them somewhere. Right, you go there, that way down, nice and safe. Right, let's get a chat phone and sort you guys out.
Green Scott 87 says, can I help with raking?
Yes, you can.
Raking Lawless says you could kill a man with those stones.
You could do. They're absolutely massive. Right, let me go and get my kneeling thing, because I think we need the kneeling. So we've got potatoes, we've got a measuring stick.
Scott 87 says, okay, I need a red rake.
Oh, did your rake ever turn up, Scott? It's interesting. Did your rake ever turn up? Okay, so this kind of always stresses me out, this job. Oh, it doesn't stress me out in like a bad way or anything. It stresses me out in the way that I just like everything looking really neat, really tidy, and sometimes it's a little bit kind of near impossible. About sort of 20 years, I think, I've had an allotment for. I've been growing stuff since... Since I was about 16. So, a long time I've been growing stuff. Okay, so the edge of the allotment kind of runs down there, and I think if I plant... we're growing Charlotte, which are an early salad potato. And then I've got two main crop varieties, Cara and King Edward. Okay, so this first row, because it's going to be mounded up, I think the first row really needs to kind of start at about 18 inches in. So maybe there. It's probably about the right sort of place. Okay, so where our potatoes have been shitting in the shed, they've got these nice little shoots now. I don't know, you'll have to get in touch with the breeder, Scott. Okay, so I hope you can kind of see what I'm doing. We're just digging down with the trowel, sort of about as deep as the trowel goes. And then I'm going to stick one potato in there. And I'm not going to worry about, at this stage, covering it up, because you're going to see what we're going to get up to in a minute. So, we're going to plant, new potatoes go in.
Greenscott 87 says, I demand we call them Princess's Charlotte potatoes, or else I start a petition.
Okay, we'll call them Princess, whatever you want to call them. Every foot now, we're going to plant a potato. And that should be plenty of distance between these. So we're going to dig down again, sort of the depth of the, the trowel. And then just stick the potato in there. It doesn't actually sit at the bottom of the hole. It probably actually only goes 4 inches deep. And then we're just going to move our little stick along and keep going. We'll probably plant... These rows should probably be about 15-foot rows. So I'm reckoning on getting maybe 12 potatoes planted. Oh, which is plenty. Which is absolutely plenty. I'm always quite interested as well with the helmet cam. You should, when you're planting seed potatoes, they should really only be as big as hen eggs. I suppose that is a big hen egg. That would have made a squawk. Occasionally. Do you know what? Over the last 20 years, right?
Scott 87 says, oh, do you want me to tell you how to adjust the cam again?
No, I don't. I've mastered that one all on my own. Over the last 20 years, I've got really good.
Scott 87 says I can see minimal movement, so I health better now.
No, it's good that you are seeing stuff. And hopefully by the summer you'll be able to see all my juicy bloody strawberries. Oh dear. Tell you what. It's no fun down here on your nose.
Dave12baby says you don't see any gardening in allotment streams.
No, that's kind of what, you know, I know the Dr. WD40, he does some sort of garden streams sometimes, but not a regular thing. I think it's been known as well. Oh dear, sorry, it's a bit old. Just a bit older and everything aches. I think it's been known that 2 minutes for Ruffin has done a gardening stream. But again, nothing kind of regular. And I do come down here and do loads of kind of stuff throughout the year. And I want to try, like I've said, to keep it to every Tuesday. So that kind of you guys know that on a Tuesday we should be down the allotment. And there's loads and loads and loads and loads of jobs for us to do down here over, you know, over the week so far. And I think we've only been coming down here sort of 5 weeks. 2 weeks we missed. So actually we've only had, I think we've only had 3 sessions down here. We've pruned the apple tree, we've made the bench in the greenhouse. I think we pruned the raspberries 1 week. We've planted loads and loads and loads and loads of seeds. What else have we done? Ah, and we tidied up all of the strawberries as well. We're probably going to have to go back through the strawberries.
Well, baby says, how are the views on the allotment compared to driving a van? Green Scott 87 says, when are we planting bananas?
Bananas. I did grow a banana plant once, Scott. It was a dwarf Cavendish. Actually, the bananas that you get are probably the variety called Cavendish. So I did in, not that greenhouse there, the one before Rester. So I need to, I do really need to sort out the allotment page on the Discord. There's a picture of my destroyed greenhouse that I want to put on there. But yeah, no, I used to probably actually, Scott, maybe about 20 years ago, I had a greenhouse at home and I grew a dwarf Cavendish.
DK_moon says, hi DJ. Haha, was just in the garden planting shallots, came in for a tea and looked at Twitch and you're planting too. How's it going?
Yeah, no, it's going well, dude. We are just planting.
Scott 87 says, oh. I am actually seeing movement on your stream, but I'm sitting live right up at the screen. Lol, I may need a computer if I keep doing that.
Truckers, he's just finished work and we've got truckers community in here. Good afternoon, trucker bandits community.
Goat Farmer Buizy says, bandit raid. 1956 says cucumbers grow really well in a greenhouse. You get loads.
Welcome in raiders. Welcome in raiders. Welcome in raiders.
87 says hello trucking people. Xanadu 2020 says Joe Hagfig sheep.
So yeah, trucker must have finished work. He's been hard at it.
Says, welcome, raiders.
He's been hard at it ever since the crack of dawn this morning. Trucker Bandit is probably one of the streams that I do watch first thing in the morning. You're okay, Farmer. How you doing? How was Trucker's stream today? Was he busy? I think he's always quite busy, isn't he? He did have a bit of a slow start. Was it today or yesterday? Can't remember now. He did have a bit of a slow start one day.
Farmer Boise says he did a lot of sitting around at
Ipco. Oh, did he? Perhaps today was the day when he wasn't too busy.
DJ, did you know
the trucks
are big? Trucks? Farmer Boise says, waiting for a bulb.
Trucks are absolutely massive, Scott. Absolutely massive. Right, this has kind of worked out better than what I thought, or maybe worse than I thought. It depends what way you want to look at it. I've only got two potatoes left, which is going to finish way early in the row. But that potato up there has kind of started in probably a bit close to that end, so I think I'm going to get that one dug up and just stick it on the end, and hopefully it's going to be a nice... We'll see. So these should be ready to dig up and eat probably 12 weeks from now. So if we're talking that we're right in the beginning of March, and there's 4 weeks in a month, 4, 8, 12, March, April, May, I reckon the first half of June we'll be digging these up and having some sort of summer salad with freshly dug new potatoes. They are the best. They are definitely the best. So how's your day, Mozzie? How is your day going? I hope you can see all right on the helmet cam. I always do get excited when I go home. And that last potato will go there. Or the one that I'm going to dig up will go there. Or should I just leave it? Yeah, I think I will get that potato and just stick it in there. Am I going to do that? I spend, probably in the winter, not very much. I don't know what to do about this. We should have, rather than going 18 inches, maybe started at 2 foot, but hey-ho, fuck it, live and learn. And then during the summer, maybe quite a lot, you know, it's just a nice place to be, you know, just cutting the grass and doing a little bit of this and a little bit of that, and not really doing very much at all. Okay, well, I think I'm going to just leave it as it is, and that's just how it's going to be. Right, I need to cut myself some more sticks, Mozzie. Need to cut some more sticks. Didn't bring the coffee down this time. Okay, so it's quite lucky that I haven't got rid of all of this. So I just want a little one like that, and probably a little one like that. And I'm just going to stick these in the ground where our last potato, so that was one potato there. And our starting potato is just there. I probably want to bury these maybe about a foot or so. So I'm just going to raise the bit of string up so that it's just about a foot. Just to give me a bit of a guideline. Oh, it's annoying. Yes, it is. That is the parcel delivery machine. Right, that can just go there. That's the parcel delivery machine.
Red Mozzie says so Sorry, mate. I am here but working at the same time, so can't talk much.
Oh, that's all right. I can talk. I can talk to you without without any response. I like talking to myself. Oh, right. Don't go anywhere, stream. Okay, so that was 3 foot. So the next row probably wants to be. Is that really 3 foot? 1, 2, 3, 4 foot. No, well, just over, just under. 4, 1, 2, 3. Okay, yeah, so that is probably about half. So it's just about 4, so I probably want to go 2 foot this end. Okay. That's our first one. No, I'm just using my big feet. I've kind of gathered that over the years my feet are about 12 inches, or my feet might. I need to measure my feet. I don't know how big my feet are. My shoes. My shoes are generally about 12 inches. So yeah, size 9. You're probably talking generally. Has sort of like 1 foot shoes, and that's just kind of how I measure sometimes. Right, chat. Can you just wait there for a moment? Talking about coffee now, I'm sort of thinking, oh, I could really do with a coffee. Right, this is the tool rack, and the tool that we want is this one here. This is a Spanish tool. I think in Spanish you call it Azada, I think that's what it is. I think it basically translates as hoe. I think that's what it is. Azada. Azada is a hoe.
No,
I'm alright Scott, we're going to run with it. Okay, so this tool here, it's a beautiful tool. It's like you would imagine, say, an African or an Indian agricultural worker in the fields, using a similar sort of tool. I suppose it is a hoe that they would use, isn't it? I think this is kind of a real basic tool, and actually in agriculture, in sort of some of the countries that still do a lot of hand farming, would use something like this. And I think before we use this, let me just put it down. I'll show you kind of the problem with a spade. So the next stage after we've planted those potatoes is we want to earth them up. Now, the spade's been used. Let me use a shovel in that case. That's fine. I'll tell you what, let's use the shovel to prop the door open. Use the spade for spading. About 30, 31 centimetres. Okay, so what we want to do now, Xanadu, is we want to earth up the potatoes, and it's a fairly easy task. And with a spade, it's just a horrific job. Basically, you just want to dig in, get some of the soil, and kind of start building up the ground around your potato. And with the spade, it's literally backbreaking work, you know. You've got to go along the row, you're kind of digging around, trying to get it all up in the middle. It's just with a spade is the worst tool for planting potatoes. So I don't know who invented this. It's got to have been the Egyptian. I don't know. I would have said it would have been the Egyptians, but maybe it was a different nation. This tool here, it's kind of like what you'd maybe see the Grim Reaper with, and this is just the best tool ever. When the ground is just freshly dug, you know, it kind of just sticks in the ground like that. It goes in really nice. That's all I can say about it, really, is it? Let me sort you out. Right, hopefully, Aho, yes, aho. So yeah, hopefully you're back around the right way now. So yeah, no, just dropping it into the ground, it drops in at a really nice angle. And here... Ah, fuck! We have got another potato. Now this is really fucking... Look at that. We can have an extra potato in the row. Oh, that's lucky. How lucky... That is... Hey, Equimage, how you doing, man? We're just planting potatoes today, and I found an extra potato. I didn't know that we had that, so that's cool. That is perfect, because that is where the row's going to finish. Beautiful. Right, that is the luck of KTL Rob Powell coming in at you at 2:30. Cut that in three and still have enough. Okay, cool. Right, that's really actually made the row much, much, much better. Okay, so our tool, we're going to call it a hoe for this instance. But yeah, I think it's a Spanish tool, maybe, because it's called an azada. Basically, because it drops into the soil so nicely, we're just going to drop it in and just pull it up. I'm hoping that the head cam is in perfect position. So yeah, I'm just gonna pull. Rather than doing it in one action, we're just gonna go along the row, up and down the row several times, just chipping away, changing the kind of, I suppose, the way that the soil is. So that's that row done. Well, not done yet. It's probably about halfway between where the other row is going to start or finish. And then we just need to go down here. And again, just earth up this side. Again, just little chips away. And this is so much easier than a spade. See, I didn't know what this tool was called. I actually bought it from a website, I think Bellotta.com. This stream is not sponsored by Bellotta.com. I was trying to find out what this tool was called, and I really didn't know what it was, but I think that I eventually found it, and it's called an azada, and I think it basically translates to hoe. Okay. So, the reason I've left a kind of a hard bit between the strawberries is I just want a piece of ground that with the Dutch hoe I can go along and just kind of chip at that and just keep the edge of the strawberries clean and tidy, if that's the word. So we're just going to go along again and just kind of, I suppose, straighten it up a little bit now. I don't think we're going to go up a third time because we don't need to. Bear in mind these are only going to be new potatoes, or the first earlies. And they're planted, this string is about a foot above where they are. So, no, I live right in the south of England, and we probably get our last frosts maybe late April, something like that. These will kind of grow underground, and I probably won't see anything emerge until maybe the beginning of April. And if we do get a forecast for frost, well, this is the thing, okay? If I'm not sleeping very well, what I will do is I will come down here and you can wash the frost off of the plants. Now, that's the thing. If a plant gets... 87 says there's frost just now. If a plant gets frost on it and the sun comes up, shines the sun onto the leaves, the cells rupture, they explode and the plant just goes like soggy, and loads of plants do it, you know, lettuces, cucumbers, the soft tops of potatoes. There's loads of plants that, you know, will suffer. But if you come down here before the sun starts rising, you know, you're talking probably in April time. You're probably talking April time. You want to be down here for about 6 in the morning, probably. And if you just water the frost off of the plants, they're fine. So, yeah, that's not a problem. Or you can fleece it with agricultural fleece, just cover the whole sort of area, which is probably the lazy version. So I think that is kind of where I want to be. Now, one of the things of earthing up the potatoes now, douse it with what? Didn't hear what we're dousing it with. Oh, water, no. I mean, soggy. You know when sort of your lettuce gets frozen at the back of the fridge? That kind of soggy. So I think this row is probably as good as I'm going to get it today. I'm actually going to take home one of those cabbages and I'm going to make a base curry sauce. I'm making tonight a chicken jalfrezi. It's probably going to take me to make the base curry sauce hour and a half, couple of hours, and then actually to make the jalfrezi probably half an hour. But I need the base curry sauce, which is the kind of the, what am I looking for? What do we do that rank? Which is kind of the, one of the main ingredients of a jalfrezi, I'm afraid. So then with the rake, I just like to turn it upside down so that the teeth on going in and just sort of flatten off the top a little bit, not anything. Not anything major. I do love a lasagna. So yeah, just flatten off the top a bit like that. And I think that's gonna be, I'm just gonna stick this under this end and pull this up a little bit, and the same to this end. So that is literally our first row of potatoes done. And we'll be digging these in the first, I would have thought first half of June. Which is good. Okay. For our next trick, we are planting two rows of main crop potatoes. The first row is going to be King Edward's, and then the second row is going to be Cara. Cool. Perfect. Absolutely perfect. I've got double allotment, and I think it cost me somewhere in the region of about 80 to 90, let's call it £90 for easy maths. So from, say, just behind the shed where the fence is, to probably, I think this is about the path that goes through the middle of the allotments. So for something like about this big in the allotment, you're talking 45 quid? Nothing really, it's quid a week. It's quid a week, and already we've got one row of potatoes in. I should have counted how many potatoes we've, well, I can tell you probably, we've got one there, they're a foot apart, so we've probably got 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 10, 11, we've probably got about 12 potatoes. But no, you're right, Cara is a really nice potato. It makes a really, 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 really good jacket potato. The skins are just like mega, mega, mega crispy. They're good for mashed potato as well. King Edwards, I don't really find them much use. Other than for a roast potato, they make. I lease it off the council. I'd love to own a little piece of land like this. It'd be beautiful, wouldn't it? I don't think the government would ever sell off allotments. 1956 says King, it's a good masher. Yeah, see, I prefer Cara for a mashed potato. Cara just seems to be like really fluffy, really light. So you can imagine in a jacket potato, you know, it being, you know, a really hard, crispy skin, sort of almost like bark. That's probably, I don't know, the best way to describe it. But inside, the potato is just so light and fluffy. And I think for a mashed potato, yeah, Cara's really good. You know, don't get me wrong, King Edward does mash really well. But I think Cara, for me, is the potato of mashers, maybe. But I quite like my mash a little bit chunky in any case. I know you can sort of watch these restaurant programmes and they run it through rices and stuff, don't they, to kind of get it silky smooth. I'm not sure that I'm a silky smooth mash man. Okay, so I'm going to keep this stick because this could be actually useful throughout the year when planting maybe our broccolis and our lettuces. Davey, I'll catch you later, mate. It's really tasty. I'm going to bring chat with me. I'm sorry I left you here. See you later, Davey. Have a good day, man. Thanks for coming in and joining us. Yeah, mashed potato is, you know, I think you can do loads with it, can't you, Scott? You know, it's absolutely one of the best. Okay, so we'll keep that. Okay, our next potatoes to go in the ground are main croppers. Main croppers you plant 15 inches apart. I need to get a brand new stick. Where's my cutters? 15 inches. I wonder if I've got a stick that's 15 inches. So yeah, everything has its kind of distance to be planted apart. The reason you plant them further apart than the first earlies or second earlies is because literally you're going to be digging them up as young baby potatoes and they don't need the room to expand. Whereas a main cropper, you want that space between the plants that can grow sort of a bigger canopy of green leaves, and that's going to obviously supply the energy to the tubers and the potatoes. Hopefully, well actually, do you know what? Every time I've grown potatoes, they're really shit. Because I don't water them. That's the thing. Potatoes love a lot of water. So for the last probably, I don't know, 8 years, 10 years, I just go over to that water trough over there and give them, I think about 12 litres of water a day, something like that. Just sort of walk up and down the rows, two watering cans. And that really does give you a potato that is worthy of being called a potato. Now, this stick looks like it could be 18 inches. Ah, fuck, I've left chat in the shed again, sorry. Let me just chop off these little branches. Sorry, I didn't mean to leave you in the shed all on your own. Sorry, chat. Sorry. I really don't mean to do that. Okay, let's see what's going on. Liver and mash. Yeah, no, I do like liver and bacon. That is one of my... you see, when the kids go out, when Rachel goes out, I do... there's a couple of meals that I eat because they don't like them. Liver and...
1NALN1GHTMARE3V3 says you keep leaving us behind long.
I know, I need you really on my wrist, but it's not really a kind of a... be on your wrist day, so yeah, we're just gonna have to bear with it. I don't mean to leave. Just imagine how my kids felt, always being left behind. You know, you go back into the shop and the kids been there crying for the last 2.5 hours, and you're like, 15 inches. Wow, just about there.
Scott87 says again, FFSDJLUL.
For fuck's sake, yeah, I know. Right, we've got a 15-inch stick now. So, yeah, that should be perfect. I don't think I need the cutters out here. Yeah, I don't mean to leave you behind, Scott. It's just something that happens. Okay, I think in that row, I need to leave you outside again. I'm gonna this time leave you on the.
Great Scott 87 says I'm never relying on you guiding me about. You'll leave me to walk into lampposts.
Right, I'm gonna leave you here sunbathing in the middle. Okay, can you see yourself sunbathing? And then I just need to go and get the other potatoes. That stick can go over there. It's awful. Okay, right. We've got a 15-inch stick. So we are making progress. We're making progress with everything. We've got our peas coming up. The potatoes are going in. I think actually this is probably one of the years. I'm really, really ahead with potato planting. Normally, I don't really get the potatoes in until April. So, okay, first, I think we'll do King Edwards. They're Cara. These are King Edwards. There's going to be a few left over, I'm sure. But yeah, a row of potatoes is literally just enough for us. Well, the potatoes we've got left in the bottom of the bag isn't many. But they're starting to shoot now, so... Hello, Azaman, how you doing? How you doing? Okay, so I think that's about the edge there, 15 inches in. That was like 12. Ah, 15 is going to be fine. Okay, so our first potato. We are planting potatoes this afternoon, Azza. We've already done the first earlies, and that's a variety called Charlotte. This is now... yes, one potato, you probably get... you probably get, oh Christ, maybe on the early potatoes you're talking, oh fuck, oh maybe 10 or 15, something like that. So you do get sort of quite, I suppose, a markup. And then again, similarly on the main crop, you probably don't do as well on the main crop. You probably only get between 8 and 10. But... I should have put my gloves back on. Yeah, well, these three rows are going to do... See, Abby and Georgia don't eat potatoes. Love stone. They don't eat potatoes for some reason. I love a spud. Mashed potato. Roast potatoes. Square potatoes. All sorts of different potatoes I like. Creamy potatoes. These three rows would do us like all year. Like I said, I've got a melt dustbin at home. Yeah, we don't really make a lot of chips, really. I've got a melt dustbin at home. The reason it's metal is because a plastic bin's going to throw. Blow away. I think that's probably one of my first things. But a metal bin's going to be totally dark, so I just figured that in August, September time, while it's still quite light, the light isn't going to get through the bin and make the potatoes go green. So that's why it's a metal bin, I think. So yeah, from harvest, which is probably, September time, we've been eating potatoes, maybe once a week, twice a week. Well, that's what I was sort of saying, Scott, that we dig them up in about, August, September time, and they've lived in the metal bin outside my house till today. They're still there. And they're just starting to sort of grow a few little shoots. All the time it's getting warmer, the shoots are going to grow. But you can pick the little shoots off at the moment, so the potatoes are probably good right till the end of March. It's just that maybe in April the shoots start to get a little bit longer, and because then the potato's actually growing, the moisture stored inside the potato is then going into the shoot, and the potatoes are just sort of maybe a little bit softer than what you'd want them to be. So there's probably nothing wrong with them going into April, May. It's just that they're just it's kind of almost worth not eating potatoes in April and May and looking forward to the ones that you dig up in June. And, I don't know whether you've ever had brand new potatoes. I call them brand new. Brand new potatoes, Scott, straight out of the garden, straight out of the allotment, right? You can dig them up, and with your fingers, you can just rub the skin, and the skin, like, peels off. You don't need... you don't need... you know, a peeler, you don't need, you know, the skin just literally falls off. You boil them, and they take a fraction of the time than shop ones do to boil. So maybe a shop potato, you're talking at needing, I don't know, 15, 20 minutes. I'll ask my dad, I'll give him a call back later. The allotment ones that you dig up, they seem to take maybe 10 or 15 minutes, a fraction of the time to cook. I don't know why. Maybe they're more tender, I don't know. Okay. Oh, fucking hell, they fell over. So, the ridges that I've built today won't be...
Devon says they might still be full of moisture from growing. Green Scott 87 says, whereas the ones that have been dug up and sitting for a while are tougher.
Yeah, the new potatoes in the shops should be fresh this year. The ones that you're buying now have just been in cold storage. So, yeah, the potatoes that you're buying from Tesco's have just been in some farmer's big fridge, effectively. And he may have also been... I don't know, douse in the atmosphere with nitrogen or something to stop them sort of stop them growing or whatever it does, the nitrogen. I think it might only be sort of apples and bananas they use nitrogen for. Stop them ripening. But yeah, the new potatoes that you get in the shop should be literally from that current growing period. So if I'm going to get a potato in here, just on the end, will I get another one after that? Ah! Reckon. Well, these are the King Edwards. Probably won't get rowing, to be honest. So yeah, I've got 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 potatoes extra if anyone wants them. And we've planted 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. I'm not really worried. I don't think that I've got 6 left over. I don't think I'm worried that I've only planted 8 because, like I said, we don't really eat a great deal of potatoes and we haven't got shit tons left. We haven't got shit tons left. But, you know, there's a few in the bottom of the bag. So, you know, if last year I planted 9, then 8 won't be a problem. 8 won't be a problem at all. Okay, cool. I'll put the kneeling pad back at this end. And we're kind of back in business. We need... I'll tell you what. My brain's like soft cheese, I reckon. Oh, no, I left chat behind. Okay, let me get the sticks. So that I don't think I needed. That. Okay. do like a lasagna. So getting the same as the other one, I'm just going to put a stick in there where the last or the first potato was, and again up here. Again up here, just another stick, you can go there. Right, let me get a chat. Yeah, that is, it's really, well, I'm going to put you there, chat. And again, I think I want to go just probably a little bit higher than a foot. One of the reasons, or one of the ways potatoes grow, or not one of the ways that potatoes grow, as the stem comes up, they throw shoots out the side, and that's where the potatoes grow. So it's not that the potatoes grow down, if that makes sense, they kind of grow up. So by having the soil a little bit higher, hopefully you're getting that, you know, that maybe extra one. So, you know, it's not many potatoes when it comes to it at the end of the day, one. But you know, if you're talking it's extra 8 potatoes, that could be the choice between, you know, having potatoes in February or not having potatoes in February. It's not really that bad. But yeah, I suppose being a farmer, you want to try and supply yourself enough food to last right the way through. And I thought, well, probably could do it. Probably could do it. Ah, right, okay. So before I start earthing them up, what I want to do is I'm going to take out these poles here, and we're now going 4 foot between rows. 1, 2, 3, 4 foot. Oh, that'd be my dad again, probably. Oh, he wants me to go get a fence panel with him. I can do that. Do that later, maybe. Yeah, it's my dad. That actually looks a bit too much of a gap. Sorry, final night, Ellie. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Probably 3 foot then. 3 foot. 1, 2, 3. Yeah, that looks better. What's 3 foot? 12, 24, 36, probably only one. If you're planting the potatoes 30 inches apart or 15 inches apart, the rows probably only want to be 30, so 36 is what we're going to have to deal with today. 1, 2, 3 foot. So that is... Oh, come on, go in. I'll have to do this. Okay, so that basically gives me where our next line is going to kind of go, and it just allows me to take the soil from somewhere in the middle. That's really all it is. So, right, let's have a look, see what final might else saying. That's not what I wanted to happen.
Xanadu 2020 says definitely, and so young.
Okay. So now we know half where halfway kind of is. With the tool that makes this job a dream, we're just going to drop it in. Whereas the other row, we went up about 2 or 3 times. This row here, we'll go up probably 3 or 4 times. Just sort of chipping away, bringing the loose soil up.
Epic 1NALN1GHTMARE3B3 says, yeah, only 52.
Yeah, it's young, isn't it? So, again, yeah, I'm actually going to take a little bit more soil from the other side because I've just thought that this row here probably wants to go over half a foot actually. That's fine. So again, this side we're gonna kind of just chip away at what's there. Such the best tool in the world. Okay. Starting to look alright. I want to take a bit more soil actually off of this next row, because otherwise I think we've got 3 foot, 3 foot, whereas with between here we've had 2 foot. And then 1.5 foot, so you know what I mean. You know what I mean, chat. You do know what I mean. Oh, Scott, I missed your call last night, right? I was actually on the computer. I was doing some work. I was getting ready for my London trip, to be honest. And then I didn't see that you'd phoned me. Discord didn't ring for some reason. I don't know why it wasn't ringing. Sometimes it does that. Just doesn't ring. Doesn't ring. So what's going to happen now, probably over the next month or 6 weeks, is we're going to get a lot of seeds growing on these. Yes, we are, Nightmare. We are going as a stream. And we're going to go on my version of Monopoly. That's what we're going to do. So stay tuned for some more Monopoly information coming up. Like, literally, I had it all in my shopping basket, the train ticket. The ticket was a tenner. I did have a look yesterday, I think, or the day before yesterday, and it was still a tenner, so we're in for a bit of luck. But the thing was, right, is I was kind of hesitant, because it's George's birthday over the next few weeks, and I didn't want to kind of clash. So I was like, oh, George, I'm going out to London. She's like, oh, Dad, I hate you. It's my birthday. You could have done it any other weekend except for this weekend. Why did you have to choose this? But I said to her, I said, hey, George, what are you doing for your birthday? Expecting us to say, oh, well, you know, Dad, we'll do this, and then we'll go out for a bit of food, and then we'll do whatever. And she's like, oh, I'm going out with my mate, and I don't know what we'll do. We might do this and we might do that. And I'm like, oh, okay. So Dad's just on, like, the shelf now, is he? Is he just, like, some sort of taxi driver? So, yeah, that's just got when the kids growing up, I think. I mean, no, I didn't want to hang around my dad when I was 17, that's definite, sure. That's definite. Right, so I think we've kind of do you see how much bigger that row is? I don't know if you can see how much bigger that row is than the other one. It's quite a lot bigger. Yeah, I mean, what kid, Scott, really, honestly, at 17 wants to hang around with their dad? Okay, so again, with the same as we did on the other one, I'm just going to flatten off the top a little bit. Okay, sweet. Okay. So that is our second row. Yeah, maybe. Yeah, true. So, over the next, month, 6 weeks or so, there will be some weeds growing up. But basically all I'm going to do is I'm going to walk between the rows, and where we've pulled the earth up today, I'm going to actually pull the earth back down. You probably think, oh, what a waste of time. But no, the weeds that are going to grow, I'm going to kind of go along with my little draw hoe and kind of chop the soil, chop the weeds back down to the ground and leave it again for maybe another 3 weeks. By that point, everything's going to be really growing well. And then 3 weeks later, pull the soil back up. So any weeds that have grown in that period, hopefully, will be disturbed, pulling back up. And yeah, hopefully that's going to be keeping us weed free, or as weed free as we can keep it. If I get the energy or the free time, I might just walk down in the middle of these rows with a spade and just break the soil up a little bit, so as you walk up and down it, you sort of crunch it a bit more, ready for, you know, the earthing up sort of process. So that is the King Edward's done, and yeah, last row. I was down here the other night until yesterday, half past five, rotivating. And the sun hadn't even gone down yet. You know, a few weeks ago we watched the sun go down over there, and I think it was about just coming up to, I think you, Scott, thanks for hanging out with us. I'll catch you a little bit later. Don't enjoy your eye squirting too much. So yeah, I think Scott was here, definitely. I think the sunset, when we was talking about it, it was maybe about 4 o'clock back then. Okie dokie. Well, hopefully your squirty oi thingy will solve it. Well, I'm just going to have to leave you there for a moment, chat. Just behave for a second. See, I'm not sure that we'll get on to doing some seed stuff today. Yeah, I spend loads of time out down here during the sort of spring and summer. Kind of get, a bit of an accelerator. I wanted to move this about half a. Should we say? Is that about? That's probably about half in a chat. dead one over. There we go. But no, actually, I'm really glad how far we've kind of got down here, really. So this one's to go about half again. I'm hoping, I really look forward to watching these head cam kind of streams, just to sort of see how well they work or don't work. I was a bit unsure. Enough bloody stone this end. That's two stones in two holes. Ticken said that there would be an element, and I did quite think myself, that there'd be an element of seasickness or head shakiness, or I think shakiness more than anything. But actually watching a couple of the streams back, I don't think it was that bad. And no one really sort of said, oh no, this is really terrible, so. So, all in all, I think things are going to work out good for us, chat. I'll tell you why I was having problems on that other row, not really major problems. I just didn't rake it flat. Rake it flat this time. So yeah, I think things are going to work out for us all right, chat. You know, the new round isn't obviously as many parcels as we were used to. Which, it's annoying, it's more annoying because it just means where everything was kind of nicely sorted and, you know, life was ticking along nicely, suddenly it's just a little bit different. But I think really the benefit for us over the next couple of weeks is while I'm looking for some more work to do, we're going to get out and do some more IRL stuff. I was going to say shite, but it's not shite, is it? It's good, I like it. So yeah, this row's probably the fattest of our rows. Probably actually want to take a bit more up on that other row, to be honest. Yeah, because we're going halfway between, aren't we? And I think we've got a bit more. Then we've got a bit more soil to chop on that one. Let's just take a little bit more. Oh. Do I reckon about there, maybe? The best tool in the world, this is. Best tool in the world. The strawberries, I think, we're going to move this year. They've been down in this spot. This is probably getting on for probably the fourth year. And you're supposed to kind of move strawberries every 2 or 3 years. Right, that's kind of as good as we're going to get, and then when we see the potatoes come up, we kind of alter the look of our row, maybe. Right, chat, I'm just going to be back. I could actually do a drink. And this row will be Cara. dear, my nose is a bit runny actually. Okay, I think that's probably the edge of the allotment there. Yeah, we've kind of, the sun's gone behind some clouds at the moment, but it was nice and sunny. Okay, let's get these in. Then we can get home and put our feet up, cook some curry, a jalfrezi, so that's our first spod. I'll tell you what, actually, any of you that... I think I missed a TTS message, let me go and get you. Any of you that were tuned in Sunday night, me, Red Muzzy, Jack and Willie, we did an impromptu untitled chat show for the Ukraine fundraising thing. What the fuck's that? That's Dandelion. I think our total's quite high now, actually. It's like close or well above $2,500. So, yeah, for everyone who's donated and contributed with time, you know, that's a really, 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 really massive total. And that excellent fucking excellent result for that was on the Untitled Network. You should give that a follow, actually. I don't know whether we've got anyone in the chat who can give that channel a shout-out. Can someone give that channel a shout-out? It's a channel that we don't actually use anymore. Well, I don't say we use anymore. It's just a channel we don't use very often. We used to do a chat show every Friday. It's really, really, really good. Willie did a quiz, Jack was there, Mozzy was there. It was a real kind of... it is resting, yes. It's having a bit of a holiday. It was just where a group of us used to hang out and, you know, talk to another streamer. Yeah, that's really, 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 really a good sort of period of our lives. It was kind of one of those COVID concepts. And it, yeah, no, we had a good time over the... I think it was on for a year, maybe. Maybe a little bit longer. No, I had a really good time on the Untitled Chat Show. Resting, just like I should be, Jelly Bean. So what do you reckon so far, Jelly Bean? We've not done too bad, have we, with the potatoes? This is kind of always, I think, the slow kind of bits of, well, it's all slow really, isn't it? You know, you plant the potatoes 12 weeks later, we're talking about 16 weeks for main crop. So yeah, 12 weeks for early, 16 weeks for main crop. Plenty of water. Jellybean 1956 says it. Yes, it is! Exclamation point, shout out. Anyone can do shout outs on the channel, so if you know of anyone who's like an IRL streamer, give them a shout out as well, because we're trying to grow the community. Cool. There you go, Big Toe Dan. That is the Untitled Network. We haven't got 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. Yeah, we've got actually more potatoes in this row than we did the other row, which is a bit weird. Don't know who I'm going to blame that on. That's weird. So we get 9 in one row. Maybe I can't count. I'm sure it was 8. I'll have to, when we're going on the VOD, I'll have a double count. And this Cara's full right, having an extra potato. Oh! Did we lose a potato? Did I lose a potato in this row? And then, oh no, that was the first row, wasn't it? We lost one. So I've only got 2 left. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. I think I have got an extra row, an extra one in that one. Doesn't really matter. I don't think we need the kneeling pad anymore. A nice straight marking stick. Probably that one looks good. Probably not as long as I wanted it to be. It's always the way though, isn't it? Never as long as you want it to be. Just want something a little bit, that one looks sort of fairly straight. Okay. Right, there's one marker there. And that is our other marker there. We're going to pull our bits of string up again. So we're sort of well over a foot. Well over a foot under the ground there. I'm going to save my 15 inch. What else will I plant this year for 15 inches? Do I need the trowel? Probably not. 15 inches. Ah, maybe main crop cabbage. Main crop cabbage, probably go 15 inches plot. So that can go there in the stick pile. That lives just there. Yeah, no, I've done really well. Well, I did want to actually get over into that area today and sort of give that a bit of a clean up. Let's go and have a look. But I don't think we're going to have time. I think we've literally got time to earth those up. And we're done again. It's amazing how quickly the time goes. So probably over the next week or so. Probably over the next couple of weeks, actually. We want to sort of clear this area a little bit. Get this dug. Because I want to get the onions in. I did want to probably get them in maybe next week or something, but we can do something different next. We can probably tidy up next week. I want to get... I'll tell you what we'll do next week. We'll make a new lid for the cold frame. I actually do want the cold frame. out of here today. I think I want it. I think I want some of my brassicas to go outside. Ah, oh, I've left chat behind again. Right, you stay there, cold frame. Okay, let me sort out a message. Sorry, I didn't mean to leave you behind. Sorry. Yeah, no, the thing, yeah, no, you're right. You're definitely right, Jellybean. Maybe I should move the plastic trays. I'll throw something over, like a, I don't know, just those trays. Yeah, oh, maybe I'll throw this over a stop and blow. Yeah, so over the years, obviously, Jellybean, it's obviously got a little bit old and fallen apart. But we can make a new one. I've got all of this wood. This wood's probably a little bit thick, actually, for making a frame like that. Got some in the shed, actually. Got some batten in the shed. Maybe that's probably worth it. Oh, I'll tell you what, we've got that batten over there. I was going to use that bit of wood. So this batten over here is what we're going to use, I think. But I was going to put a couple of strips under the bottom, but I think these stands that we've got just don't... I don't need that wood on the bottom, so yeah, we're at an advantage. So yeah, that's good. We're on the up. We're on the up. Oh dear, so I can't remember how long I've spent digging this area. How long have we spent digging? Probably, maybe a couple of hours, which is probably a bit high. A couple of hours digging. Then today we've spent another couple of hours planting. So say five, oh, an hour rotivating yesterday. So say 5 hours, say we've been here for 6 hours so far. Not bad for potatoes all winter, is it? It's like a day's work. A day's work for all your potatoes. What have I done with me? Azada. I think it's an azada. See, they're the sort of questions we need, Jellybean, on the quiz. You know, a Spanish implement that looks like a Grim Reaper's thingy. What would you call that for gardening? I don't know. So in any case, you only know a question, you only know the answer, if you know the answer. Oh dear, do you like my reasoning? You only know the answer if you know the answer. So, again, anyone that's just come in, I'm DJ. We are down the allotment on Tuesday afternoons. It's kind of like our little bit... Only music, right. We'll be alright with the music, I think. So yeah, every Tuesday chat, we're down the allotment, hopefully now throughout the whole of the summer. Hopefully I can kind of do stuff at the weekends and while you're not around, so that when we do come down, the time spent together is kind of rather than us digging for 2 hours and you guys getting bored as, I could do the digging in my spare time, and then hopefully on a day like today, you get to sort of do the potato, you know, the good stuff, the potato plant, yeah. So I think where maybe a lot of people go wrong is they try to kind of do the actions in one hit. So people try to make the ridge in one go. Whereas I think over the years I've kind of learnt that, you know, little and often wins the race. I keep, not really here, just a digging hoe. Yeah, I've never really seen one of these as an English tool though. I've always kind of seen them in, you know, sort of films as being one of those sort of tools that you'd use in the mountains or something like that.
Jellybean 1956 says
they
could be a draw hoe.
Yeah, I suppose it could be something along those lines, like a draw hoe. It's got the same sort of action, hasn't it? I've got a draw hoe in the shed, and you know, if you put them side by side, you could almost say that they were identical. Obviously there's a little bit of a shape difference, but that's down to manufacture. So yeah, maybe you're right, maybe it's just a draw hoe. Maybe I'm just trying to posh it up too much. So, I think, for the time being, that is a very similar... Oh, where's the rake gone? That's a very similar height to the other one. Well, similar height, similar shape. So I think all I'm gonna do is just go along here, straighten this up. And then again, just flattening off the ridge. I think I'll do this because when the farmers grow potatoes, that's kind of how their machinery leaves it, in that sort of shape. Okay. Other than the ends probably needing a bit of tidying up, with that side shaping a little. Hey, Night, how you doing, man? How you doing? Tuesday afternoons, dude, is our allotment session. So if you fancy a little bit of fresh air, a little bit of digging, Tuesdays you'll find us down here, man.
Xanadu 2020 says hello.
So, I think before we get too carried away, I'm just going to pull some of that excess soil over, make that a little bit flatter. So I'm just going to put you this over there, chat. Yeah, I did some grass cutting yesterday. The smell of freshly cut grass is amazing. Right, that I think I'm happy with. Thinking of that's the word adza or I don't know how you say that, adza something. Yeah, cool. So I think we've achieved our mission today. We've planted the earlies, two main crops. I would like, hopefully, this row of potatoes to kind of maybe grow or come up. Okay. I'd like the potatoes maybe to come up this side of the ridge, and then we can pull some of the soil up to kind of effectively move that row a little bit. Oh dear. So that is one mission accomplished. We can put our tools away. And then I think it's probably about time that, you know, we say our goodbyes again. I think over the next few days, we're gonna, or say we, maybe we could have another session down here if you fancy. Over the next couple of days or so, I want to get back in the greenhouse and plant some more lettuces. The sorry, I was smashing you down. I didn't realise I was doing that. Okay, so that tool for the next 12 months then just lives up there. I know that I probably spent £30 or £40 on that tool. And I only literally use it for a couple of hours on, you know, the afternoon I plant it. And I may use it again while I'm earthing up, earthing down the potatoes. But I definitely think it's well worth the £30, as opposed to using the spade. You saw how much effort the spade was. It's kind of almost backbreaking using a spade to earth the potatoes up. But yeah, with that tool, it kind of just literally, I think the strengths in your, or the work, I don't know where the work comes from, comes from your arms, I think maybe. You lift it up and the weight of the tool is enough to sort of chip it into the ground enough to get the soil that you need. Oh God, I can't undo that. Oh, there you go. So I will sit down tonight, chat. I will get onto the Discord and create an allotment channel. And I will try to blog our weeks down here. Once I say goodbye to you, I will take a photo of our potato ridges and that will sort of form the next, I suppose, the next picture or the next part of the story. Yeah, beautiful. So yeah, June time, we'll start digging up these potatoes and everyone's a winner. Everyone is a winner. I just never really get those. I would, in a different place, probably have given more space between the first earlies and the main crop. But because I'm in this bit behind the strawberries, I haven't got that luxury. But, you know, that's just the way that it is. It's just the way that it is. Tomorrow I've got a black spot removal job. I think that's literally just sprinkle some of his liquid on the patio, give it a bit of a scrub with the broom, and then just jet wash it off. Okay, let's have a quick. I think I need anything from out of there. Let's go and get chat. Just keep leaving you behind. Cool. So yeah, I think we've had another successful day. We've got the potatoes in, that's for sure. So yeah, no, it's been a mission and a half, chat, but we've done it. We have done it. So let's go in the greenhouse. And then I'll find that, oh, it's lovely in here. And then I'll find just another. And then I'll find another channel for us to raid into. But it's all growing in here, Nighty. We've got our poppies growing. I don't know whether Mozzie's still in the chat. But Mozzie, those seeds that I sent you, this is the other half of the packet growing sort of quite nicely. So, yeah, be planting those somewhere around. We've got a bit of beetroot, sunflowers, a few Mozzie. These are the poppies that I sent you. I found half a packet of seeds. We planted them the other day. When did we plant these ones? 22nd of February. So these have all come up really good. So yeah, we'll be sticking those. Don't know where I'm going to stick them yet, but yeah. We've got the Brussels sprouts there, we've got some purple sprout and broccoli, some cabbage, and all of our shallots. So, you know, it's all going good. It's all going good. Right, guys, I'm going to find a channel on Twitch. Hopefully there's another... we've got 8% battery. Hopefully I've got enough battery to raid you. I'm going to find another IRL streamer, hopefully, to raid you into.
Mozzie says, so I may get a good opium haul soon then.
Yeah, I don't...
Mozzie says, hi,
night. Yeah, I don't think these ones are... I don't know, actually. I don't even know if you could test them to tell whether they are.
Graftark says, just wanted to pop in and say thanks for the stream.
Graftark.
Linny Walks is live if you want to raid IRL.
We'll go with Linny. She's either with the horse or doing something. Graftark, thank you for the follow, dude. I'm DJ and I'm a variety streamer, so we will be doing everything. We're going to go fossil hunting this year. We're hopefully going to be meeting up with Mozzie again and, you know, some of the other guys. Hopefully heading down to Cornwall, meeting up with KTL Rob Powell. You know, we've got loads going on. So if you've enjoyed this afternoon, hopefully you'll enjoy some of the other stuff we do. You know, we hang out doing parcel deliveries. There's a cooking stream Thursday evening. So, yeah, I do kind of, you know, a lot of kind of different things. I need some battery for this phone. It's just gone dark on me. It's just gone dark. But no, it's been really, 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 really.
2020 says, see you later at DJ underscore technique.
Xanadu.
Sergeant underscore psychotic says, yo, yo, yo.
Xanadu.
Mozzie says you want me to raid.
Oh, yeah, Mozzie, can you... Oh, no, because I don't think I'd get a timer then. I'll do it because then I can see the countdown. Because I think when you do it, I think you get a countdown on the Twitch thing, but I don't get to see anything. It's a bit like, how many seconds? And then suddenly you're gone and I'm just talking to myself. Let's go /raid. Oh, that's not how you spell raid. Linny Walks. Cool. Viewers, please hang around for the raid. We are off to Amsterdam or somewhere in the Netherlands. Linny Walks.
Red Mozzie says, cheers, DJ.
Does loads of stuff similar to what I do. You know, she walks around cities. She does stuff with horses.
Greg Best 90 says, dang, I was too late. Take care, DJ.
Oh, Greg Best. Thanks for popping in, dude. We've planted our potatoes today. So if you fancy watching a bit of the allotment VOD, it's all about planting potatoes today, man. Good to see
Red
you.
90 says nice. Red Mozzie says hi at SGT underscore psychotic.
Everyone
NALN 1 GHTMARE 3B3 says Linny is in Portugal.
Oh, is she? Oh, cool. Well, it looks like you guys are off to Portugal then. I'm going to take you out of the shed and give you a bit of, I would say, a sunset. Oh no, I've run out of battery. Oh, you got... Oh no. How did I just unplug you and you ran out of battery? Oh no. You guys are definitely off then. I don't know how many seconds. So there's me, Mozzie, going, oh, I need to do this. And then I don't know how many seconds you've got. And then you won't... Then I won't disappear without you knowing. And suddenly, I've got no battery. Oh dear, I'm probably here talking to Right, let's turn this phone on, see if you guys are still there. Don't think you are, you've probably gone by now.